Yeah. Well, good evening. My name is Jeremy, and I'm one of the pastors here at Shepherd of the Valley. On behalf of Shepherd of the Valley, and also the St. Croix Valley Symphony Orchestra, we want to welcome you to an evening of music. Can we give Dr. Chris Turnahoy and the team here another round of applause, please? One of the beautiful things about music is that it can short-circuit the parts of our brain that get so busy and get so caught up in schedules and things to do and all of that. And so this evening, if you are an old friend here again for the time, or a new friend that we haven't met yet, allow yourself to just pause. Pause and let the music sink deep and touch you with a story. The story of one who was born and came into the earth for all of us. And as this expression, one of our expressions of worship here at Shepherd of the Valley, we value the way that music, it touches our soul. And so our prayer for you tonight is that you would see and hear the beautiful things that are created here by the work of these people, and that you would be able to give thanks to God. In fact, let's do that right now. Let's pray. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good and his mercy endures forever. Father, I thank you for the gifts represented in this group. And I thank you for the beauty of music that you created. And then invite us to join you in expressing. Lord, we pray that you'd be with us this evening through song. And that we pray that your spirit would well up in us this Christmas. In Jesus' name, amen. I would be remiss if I didn't invite you back for our Christmas Eve services. They're found at the bottom of your bulletin, and they'll be on the screen periodically. Thank you so much for joining us this evening.
Like a tidal wave, oh, I'm an ocean. Thank you. Thank you.
A reading, the story of Jesus' birth foretold from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 1. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, to a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored, the Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she who is said to be unable to conceive is in her sixth month, for no word from God will ever fail." "I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May your word be to me fulfilled." Then the angel left her. The birth of Jesus, from Luke chapter 2. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was the governor of Syria. And everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and the line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over the flocks by night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths, lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly hosts appear with the angel and praise God, saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off, and they found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread word concerning what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds had said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. And now, the purpose of Jesus' birth from the Gospel of John. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who did receive him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God, children not born of natural descent nor of human decision or a husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. Out of his fullness, we have all received grace in place of grace already given. For the law was given through Moses, but grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God, but the one and only Son, who is himself God and is his closest relationship with the Father, has made him known. Here ends the reading.
Thank you. Thank you. Chat with you out there, and again, thank you for coming and sharing your music.